Hello everyone, I am Dylan. Welcome back to my therapy. We got Kimiko, we got Yui, sup? And apparently, I'm worthless. She busted through the wall because she has an enormous amount of strength.
Is she gone?
That's normal. We exchange glasses with Yui. Sup?
Hey! I ain't no rat!
Same. We stepped into the corridor. Yui didn't say anything. I just followed her. I'll see where this is going! This game is a little bit unpredictable. Tell you that right now. So, what do you exactly need help with? I don't know. Did I see something wrong?
Where did you get the idea that I need your help?
You asked! You said that you... Whatever. What?
Please, come in here.
What's happening? This music sounds like the ocean theme from Super Metroid. It's beautiful in here! Look at all the arch! And I hope it's not a diaper. Is that Half-Life? She showed me some disgusting room. The white walls are covered in graffiti and various languages and cultures. No smoking! A pile of cigarette butts surrounded by a puddle of damp papers and some shards of glass. The wires were the fire alarm was disabled. There's definitely a bathroom! I heard Yui lock us in. Oh! Dang it! Oh no! What's happening?
An acquaintance!
Are we in the toilet?
Look how smart you are!
Why? Instead without an eye! She poured out two cans of beer. No thank you! She pushed up right in the puddle, especially me right in the face, and canned me one can. Blah! Why is it gotta be water from the bathroom?
Cheers!
Instead of opening the can normally, she shotgunned it. Nope.
Childhood memories!
That's unfortunate. I'm sorry. Blah! How odd. She first grinned in satisfaction, then looked toward me excitedly.
What are you doing standing there? Drink it.
Stay out of here! No!
Drink it!
Let me out!
I said drink it, or I'll get very upset.
Alright.
Fine.
Parts of the far wall opened a small window, waved the keys by her nose, and threw them out the window. Oh! Darn, I'm trapped in here! I'm not trapped in here with you. You're trapped in here with me. Right. What have you done?
Happy now.
No.
Drink it, and you will be.
I stood there in the middle of this filthy bathroom, barely holding the can in my hands. Just drink it.
Oh, jeez, Rick. I'm gonna drink it.
Come on, Morty. Just drink it. We gotta get out of this bathroom. I opened the beer. Foam spreading all over my head. She could barely contain her excitement. Alright. I took a sip. Man, I tell you right now, if you've never had a beer, the first beer you will have, unless it's like flavored, it will taste like garbage. It's not for me. It does not taste good. It's like drinking a Mountain Dew that's been sitting out in the sun for a long time. And then, like, mosquitoes came by, sucked out all the sugar, and then... someone dropped a piece of mud in there. It is very bad, yeah. Sour, bitter, and stinky, which is every single name people used to call me in elementary school. Uniformly bad. The days are black.
By the gods! I swear, it's like a wind spinning up my chest. I thought you don't drink.
I don't drink in the bathroom.
Well, excuse me. Kimiko has ears and eyes everywhere. It's hard to find a place where she won't sniff out my hiding spots. And yes, I do have that thing where my brain pushes the words around. It makes it really hard to read. Alright, if you'll excuse me.
What? She gotta go to the bathroom. Nah. Blah. Some people are just different, man. I don't want to be in the bathroom while you do that. No, come on. I saw one of her legs. Yeah, I don't ever sit on the public toilets. I put the paper down. I don't know. I mean, even then, I try not to sit on the toilet.
Oh my, so delicate.
Are we in the woman's bathroom?
What's the difference? Aren't we all one family?
I guess so. No. I turn towards the sink to look at the open can. On one hand, it's possible to drink something I've labeled as disgusting. I don't think it's all with a clear head. I chug the entire can down. Freak the tank! Freak the tank! Freak the tank! Ah, I don't know. Not for me. Not for me. It's not my drink. Sorry.
Yo! Nicely done.
Are you watching me?
Ouch! There are no napkins or anything out there anywhere.
There's some on the floor.
It's used.
Ah! That makes it so much better. I want to die.
Hey, can you some... Here. The papers are a notepad for me?
Blah! No.
Come on, Linda, help again.
Blah. I tore out a couple sheets and handed them to her, trying to move as far away from the stall as possible.
Merci beaucoup! You want an autograph?
I will pass! No. She threw him out of the stall. Gross!
The paparazzi will pick it up.
Please! Wash your hands. That's all I ask. You are a bit odd.
And it turns out I'm just mind blowing.
Well, sure. I leaned over the can again, just coincidence. There's nothing left in there anymore. She saw someone for two more. When will this end?
Never!
I mean, we ain't gonna let me out of here. So, did you even... wash your hands.
Look at him! He's picturing a free beer and he's whining! Stop your whining! May I live like this?
What? What does that mean?
I live like this!
Question mark? Nobody asked you for this, so you don't deserve any gratitude. What?
Hey! Although, on the other hand, I love being quoted.
Hands up! It's the wash your hands police! You're under arrest for not washing your hands!
But actually, for once I'm here talking about someone other than myself.
What's this? Why are you doing that with your... Ow! I still didn't wash my hands.
I know! I would love if you wash your hands! Like, immensely! It is necessary for me to be around you.
Tell me what happened.
Sure. Nice. So for the first time, she looked at me with a calm gaze. Without these huge glasses destroying her pupils, she had a completely different look. I was on the stream when he drew this. It's awesome! Suvorov. Ever! What? Nothing ever happened. Everything is fine. Oh, probably going, everything. Nothing happened. Everything's fine.
Listen. People don't just start drawing dead animals. When everything is fine, people don't hang around with the random classmates all day long. Because they're afraid of being left alone with their thoughts. And that would prefer any company to themselves.
Say your business. Wash your hands!
This happened not so long ago, and you haven't told anyone before, right?
Surprisingly, you look like experience. Yes, it's very obvious that Yui's had a very difficult life. And if you cannot already tell that, then unfortunately, you do not have a difficult life. Like, people all the time are complaining about, like,
I don't have the iPhone 35, I only have the iPhone 34.
I totally didn't have my coffee at the coffee place. You ever have someone you love just disappear out of your life? Or, you know, have every single day you're not sure if the good times will ever last again? Or that one person that was always there for you was suddenly not there for you anymore? Because that sucks. And I assume something like that happened. There's always a reason why people act the way they do. Listen, I'll tell you to stop. But listen, I don't want anybody to know about it. Don't pressure me, man.
Well, of course.
Okay. I thought I'd have to defend myself a little bit further than that. I feel disarmed. My human arms! We drink the second can of bleh, much more measuredly. Trying to show and justify the silence. The logical thing to do now would be just to start editing her speech plan to change the topic. On the other hand,
I could tell her.
We might as well. Might as well. I saw you go to the bathroom. Might as well tell you about my trauma, I guess. I mean, you added to it with that, but that's fine. Can it be that this is really the first person who I'm gonna pour out into my soul? I mean, technically, it was not the first person, because I talked with the doctor, Shiro, but I assume he means, like, the actual person who's not, it's not their job to hear it. And man, if someone tells you about their trauma and stuff, it's a very difficult situation to tell someone. Like, there's a reason why people don't just tell everything about themselves immediately. It's very hard to trust other people with your actual secrets. I finished the can in one gulp. How? It's so... It's not delicious. I'll tell you that right now. It is definitely how I described it, as the Mountain Dew that sat out in the sun for a long time. Mosquitoes came by, sucked out all the sugar and flavor, and then put mud in it. That's very accurate.